So I'm here today to talk to you about an ocean of happy inspiration. So interesting that I follow up Cindy when she's talking about those happy things that she shared in her talk. It's almost like there's that synchronicity we've all been sharing. So what I'd like to do today is I'd like to explain not only what I mean by the title, but how happiness can be a spiritual practice, can shift our consciousness, can improve our health, can bring inspiration and harmony to our spirits, and I will also share what I consider Ernest Holmes' lighter side. And I also have a very special surprise at the end. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to start with a quote, which I will explain to you later. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here. You can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go up in space. With the air, like I don't care. Baby, by the way, because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy. Clap along if you know what, if that's what you want to do. Here come bad news, talking this and that. Yeah. Well, give me all you got and don't hold back. Yeah. Well, I should probably warn you, I'll be just fine. No offense to you, don't waste your time. Here's why. Hey, come on, bring me down? Can't nothing bring me down. My level's too high. Bring me down? Can nothing bring me down? I said, let me tell you now, can't bring me down. Now I'll explain more about that quote later. I can already tell by the titter in the room, some people probably already got a bit of a clue. But how many in this room can say they feel like a room without a roof?
Sometimes.
Right, right. That's like infinite possibilities. Mm-hmm. Isn't that a great line? I feel like a room without a roof. Mm-hmm. Now, it was funny, because the other day when I was talking about this, it was raining outside, and I said, well, that might not be such a good thing, a room without a roof if it's raining outside. But it's just that whole idea of the infinite inspiration, you know, that opened at the top that Ernest Holmes spoke about. So that line just so resonates with me. And then I have another question for you. How many of you believe that happiness is the truth or is a truth? Good. There's a power in happiness, isn't there? Now, so what I'd like to go into now is I'd like to just discuss how, I don't know if any of you have ever noticed this, but I always have. All the pictures of Ernest Holmes are very somber and serious. What's up with that? I like to think, I like to believe that Ernest Holmes had a sense of humor.
And he did.
And in believing this, I just happened to find this quote in 365 Science of Mind. Now, he's talking about the fact that we need to accept that there is this power that responds to our word. So he's essentially talking about the law, the power that responds to our word. And this is how it goes. Let us not put on profound. Wait, let us not be profound about this, but and put on long and somber faces as though we were carrying some mystery too great to bear. Doesn't that sound like Shakespearean comedy to you? I have a feeling he had a dry sense of humor. I really do. I can imagine my father, who had a dry sense of humor. I can imagine Ernest Holmes just saying things and meaning to be funny and nobody laughs, and then suddenly he would just like bring it out and you'd start laughing and be standing there wondering why you didn't laugh in the first place. So for me, when I read that line, I could just kind of picture his face. Maybe when he was writing it, maybe when he spoke it, whatever it was, I could see his face, and that made me smile. That made me smile. That brought a sense of happiness to me. So when we get into that place of being happy, I decided to do a little looking up of happiness and happy and all the different derivatives of happy. And so I went into my concordance of the science of mind, and I found that happier appears once, just once. Happily, once. Happiness, 14 times, better. And happy, 18 times. So there's a lot of happy going on in the science of mind, right? Is he trying to tell us something here? You know? I mean, we all know about divine and spirit and all those things, but happy is in there a lot. And so I found this following quote here in one of those that I looked up. So there is nothing in the universe that denies us the right to be happy. If our happiness does not deny or interfere with the general good. So there's nothing out there denying us our happiness, right? So what is the thing that is denying our happiness? What is it? Can anybody tell me?
Ourselves.
Yeah. Ourselves. I should say what Rick said. You know, this is the sharing time.
Yeah, right.
Come on. So that's the thing that limits us. Now, it's also what I like sometimes will say is the good news and the bad news. Because in this place, if there is any bad, which personally I don't necessarily believe there's bad, there's just different ways of looking at things. And that's what we do here, is we take the ideas or the appearances and we look at them differently in order to not only heal our own consciousness about it, but to sometimes heal the greater consciousness around us. So this is what I want to share with you as an idea for happiness as a spiritual practice. Now for myself, I find that, you know, Ed and I being in ministry together, that brings me a huge amount of happiness. Mm-hmm. And we did a workshop recently, or in teaching classes, all of this brings me a great deal of joy. This helps me to get through the regular work that I do. Because that's the joy. And so with that joy, I can carry that through and do the regular work that I do, which is an appearance that is shifting somewhere else now. Wow. At graduation would be great. So another thing, I had spoken a while ago about dancing with the divine and how dancing is a place where you just kind of like feel this inner joy and happiness that just goes on within you, right? All of that energy that you, but you just get happy. It's like you can't think about all the other things, you know? Just how your worries go away, like if you get into that place of just dancing and being free. When I was a kid, I could dance forever. You know, I would rather dance than eat. And I would do that. I would go late and come back early. And to me, it was like a meditation. That idea of dancing was like a meditation to me. So this is another way. Maybe that's a way for you to find that practice. All of these are things we can look at. Laughter and its power. Think about laughter and think about how laughter actually makes chemicals in our body respond. So we get these chemicals in our body that are responding and they're creating these endorphins, which are natural painkillers. So we have this ability to use laughter to actually bring about a sense of calm in our body. Interestingly enough, for myself, I found that meditation was always difficult for me. And it was when I did a laughing meditation for the first time in my life that my brain was silent. I finished that laughing meditation in such a place of tranquility. So there's so much power in laughter. There's so much energy in that. And laughter is just happiness on a higher level. That's what I like to think of it as. And so let's look at our bodies as we talk about this idea of what we can do with just laughter with our bodies, or happiness in our bodies. Because we have all these trillions of cells, right? And all of these trillions of cells are interacting with each other, aren't they? Mm-hmm. Well, we hope they are. Mm-hmm. If they're not, well, then we have issues. But I just had this image when I was thinking about that. Just imagine if our cells were not happy working together. Imagine what that would be like. Like, say, in my right arm, right? That the cells just somehow were unhappy and they were fighting against each other. With that, it just doesn't work. Isn't this really what disease is? It's like our cells are unhappy. There's an unhappiness going on in our cells. So without this joy and this happiness, you know, we're not in the place that we can be inspired. Because this happiness brings inspiration. It brings us into that place of a higher consciousness, into that divine mind. And so Ernest Holmes says in The Science of Mind, when man's thoughts rest entirely upon himself, he becomes abnormal and unhappy. But when he gives himself with enthusiasm to any legitimate purpose, losing himself in the thing which he is doing, he becomes normal and happy. Now, I don't know about any of you, but I can lose myself in things. And one of the things I lost myself in was something that I'm going to share with you at the end, but I was out in the yard and I had music playing. And I was raking and blowing leaves, you know, and all of that. And I was dancing around. Because when I got the music on, I'm happy. It brings me joy. Even in blowing leaves and raking them up and putting them in the trash can, you know, it doesn't matter. It's like I was just feeling this joy. And a few moments later, I realized Ed has got the back window of the house open. He's like, George! George! I was so wrapped up in this joy that I was feeling doing these leaves that I was just like absolutely in zen. It was truly zen. You know. Now, I know none of you has ever been in a place like that, right? It's not rhetorical, you can say. Yes.
Not with the leaves.
Well, I had another thing I did with the leaves too, I imagine, is raking in abundance. So it could become a very powerful prosperity consciousness thing you do. So there's many different things that we can do to feel happiness, right? And some of the happy things that just automatically come to mind for me is I'm a Disney kid. I was raised in Disney from this high up. And so anything Disney like immediately brings that happiness and that joy. And what I think it is that we become kids again. There's like that permission. Like when you step into Disneyland, you have permission to be a kid. Doesn't matter how old you are, you can be a kid. And that's what I love. And kids don't have all the inhibitions. They don't have all those little walls that they built around themselves that limit their expression in life. So then we go on to other things, which I thought was really awesome when I was thinking about this, is that there's nature. Have you ever watched nature? Mm-hmm. Can you find happiness in watching a butterfly? Mm-hmm. Doesn't it just like give you a sense of a lift? Mm-hmm. Just kind of like makes you feel free, doesn't mm-hmm. it? You know, and especially with this beautiful story we heard about the butterflies that you shared with us, Cliff. It was wonderful. And another thing is hummingbirds. And this leads me into a story, because hummingbirds are amazing little creatures. But Ed's cousin Sandra, who's like his sister, and she calls me her brother-in-law, which means deep things to me, she had for years loved her garden. I mean, years. And she'd gone out and she'd searched out the plants that would attract different kinds of things into the garden for years and years and years. And all of these years she had done this, she had never seen a hummingbird in a garden. So Ed and I were sitting there at her home one day inside the house, and she has a big glass window that you can see out into the yard. And this little hummingbird came up to the window and was just hovering right in the window, right, just hovering there. And I just nonchalantly, because I'm used to that where I was from, you saw them all the time, I just nonchalantly said, "Oh, look, there's a hummingbird." I thought Sandra was going to explode. Where's a hummingbird? It's gotta be here somewhere. And she saw it, and she was just like, there was this joy, there was this exuberance that, like, not that any of us have ever experienced that, right? You wait for things, and then something finally happens. It's like, yeah! Right?
Yeah.
But do we ever get to the point sometimes where we get so busy, like, waiting for things that we somehow miss it along the way? And then afterwards, it's like, oh. And so it's not as much fun. It's so great when you can feel it in that moment, when you can be in that place and you can feel it in that moment. So what I've done is I've saved what I would like to consider the best for last. But in ending, I'd just like to kind of give you some ideas here in using any of these aforementioned practices that I've talked about. Because what I was talking about with Sandra's, I'm talking about experiencing happiness with someone else. Don't we feel happy when we get around other happy people? Mm-hmm. So that's another way, because that's inspirational. I'm inspired by your happiness. I'm inspired by your joy. And that's part of that inspiration, that happy inspiration that takes us to that higher level. So you can use any of these aforementioned practices to help yourself to bring an ocean of happy inspiration into your life. So using happy inspiration as a spiritual practice will bring harmony to every area of your life, body, mind, and spirit. Mm-hmm. So then the last thing I would like to share with you is what I call the magic of music. And I kind of gave you some ideas of what might happen. This is my surprise, by the way. So does anybody have a favorite song that takes them out of a funk the minute they hear it? Mm-hmm. Yeah?
My favorite.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. So that song, it just takes you right out of wherever you might be in a moment. And I love that. Yeah. So we can use these principles instantly. We can use them instantly. We can just dig in and do that. Mm-hmm. So that brings me back to the first quote. So has anybody here seen Despicable Me 2? No. Well, the 8-year-old in my community did.
Yeah.
And me. Well.
But my son said I should.
Yeah, you should. Not that I'm shooting on you. So, the quote that I did earlier was the lyrics from Pharrell Williams' Happy. And I'd just like for you right now to enjoy getting your happy on, because I'm about to share with you this song, and I defy you not to be happy. And if you feel like getting up and dancing, please do and sing along.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say.
You don't wish it's time.
Make happiness spiritual practice.
Okay.